CNBC TV 18 Weekender.
A first-generation entrepreneur with a knack for risk, most renowned for its deal with Mylan in 2013, where they sold their injectables facility for a whopping 9,000-odd crores and then paying one of the highest dividends an Indian company has to shareholders. Mr. Arun Kumar of Strides Shasun is now focusing on version 2 of the company, which is most recently known for making 9 mergers and acquisitions in the span of 18 months. And today he joins me for a chat from its recently US FDA approved flagship facility, which is a huge 23 acres, to talk about what version 2 of Strides Shasun looks like. Arun Kumar, we are in your US FDA compliant gelatin facility. I understand this is one of your oldest facilities. So let's start the interview by talking about it.
This is our soft gelatin plant. It is one of the few US FDA approved soft gelatin facilities. We only make prescription drugs here. This plant was built in 96-97. It went commercial. It's one of our oldest plants, but it's got a stellar track record of compliance. We are compliant from an FDA standpoint for many, many years now. This facility approved supplies products to several countries. It's got approvals from all regulatory agencies. And this is only the gelatin block, but we have several other blocks which manufactures orals, capsules, tablets, and sachets. And now we also have a new block for ointments and creams. So this by far is our flagship facility, and we have over time built capabilities here. This is also, I like to believe, is the first manufacturing facility in India which is undergoing a very massive electronic transformation. So as of September end, this facility will be completely electronic, as in we will have no paper used here. So that's a very major program that is being installed in this facility, and we worked on it for 2 years. We have about 100 odd engineers, because it's more an IT transformation, who are associated with the manufacturing plant, and it's gone very well. We just ran a trial run recently, and it's gone extremely well. So we effectively will have nothing which is manually entered. So that just takes away all the question marks about compliance and data integrity. So, for example, if the temperature controls are not all right or the air handling systems are not working, the machine stops automatically. Nobody has to take a human decision, is not required. So, we have
no human intervention.
Eventually. So, I mean, at this time, we are still in that process of transformation. We started this 2 years ago, and by end of September, we will be done. This is a facility which is, this manufactures soft gelatin capsules. This machine here is an Italian equipment from Pharmagil. So this plant is highly sophisticated in terms of technology and equipments, and also of people quality. And here we typically a batch takes about 3 to 4 days, because gelatin takes a lot of time to dry. And so this is one of our key products. In fact, this is a product which we sell in the US. We have approximately 25% of the market. So the idea of being in soft gelatins is that prescription soft gelatins, there are very few players. I don't think there are more than about 7 or 8 companies in the world which makes RX-based FDA-approved sites, and this is one of them.
It's a prescription-based gelatin.
Correct. So, and that's very few products. So it's a niche, but it's a nice niche to have.
Okay. You have around 6 to 7 US FDA facilities, compliant facilities, and you've had a relatively good record as well in terms of US FDA. What makes you different from the rest that are facing US FDA issues?
Well, I don't think we are any different from the others. I think we are at relatively different phases of evolution. Our approach towards change in compliance is, obviously the regulatory bodies have significantly increased the ante in terms of what is expected. We probably embrace that a lot quicker than a lot of other people. So I just think that the rest of the industry is catching up. I'm not saying that we are right ahead of the curve, but I like to believe that we are amongst the few people who are ahead of the curve. We're very focused on compliance, but compliance starts mainly with the culture, right? What is the culture? What are the common behaviors we display? And in a country like us, in India, it's very hard to display common behaviors. We all have different approaches. It's extremely hard to discipline people to do things the right way. So we do a lot of things with our people engagement. First, we start with obviously the right recruitment. We believe that we should spend more time on recruitment. We train them well, we qualify them well, we onboard them well. And we are a very engaging company in terms of people management. So that's one part. But more importantly, I think the urge for us to grow at the cost of quality has never been a parameter in our strategic thinking. So for example, if your R&D is not good, your product is not good, right? So you can take shortcuts with your R&D to go to market quickly, and then you can have problems with your product. So our product robustness is a lot higher. We have very strict stage gating that if you do not have a product that meets high standards, then in terms of R&D and reproductibility in the plant, then we do not take the product to manufacture. So we'll rather not have 50 filings, but whatever we have, we like to be...
rather be selective, but the quality
so
has to be...
So obviously there. We spend a lot more time and money developing it, developing products, and we also spend a lot of time with our people engagement, so our costs probably are a tad higher than the rest of the industry. But we strongly believe that in the end of the game, the reputation matters a lot, and we'll get there.
So currently we're standing in a facility which just got inspected by the USFDA in June or July?
July, yes. Recently, yes.
Okay. And no observations in this particular inspection that took place?
Correct. It was a very successful inspection. But more importantly, it was also to covering our new block for creams and ointments. So that's a new domain that Strides has recently entered, the topicals, creams and ointments. And we have several filings from that plant. From this plant, and we got a very good outcome from the inspection.
And where do the compliance statuses of the other plants stand?
All of them are currently FDA compliant. Some of the Sachin facilities were recently inspected, they also are compliant. But we are making significant investments in the merged entities for us to take it to a very high standard, and that's why I spend more time now in the facilities in Tamil Nadu, because we have three FDA-approved plants, and I believe that it will take us a little more time to get to these levels, obviously, but they are highly compliant as we speak. What we are doing also, the electronic intervention, the paperless manufacturing, that will take about a year or two. So I think in about 2 years, we believe that all our facilities will be of one uniform type, but currently the flagship plant is the only one which is getting all the attention in terms of investments, because this, like I said, started 2 years ago.
CNBC TV18 Weekender.